This is the owner of the tavern's room. You could so you know you're not going to be late for dinner or breakfast even. And as you can see, Rowan is a well-read individual. He's a cultured owner of a tavern, not just any old owner of a tavern. Next, let me take you into the hardware shop. In the hardware shop, you have random people floating in the air. Other than that, you have stuff that is hardware related, such as doors. Doors, yes, you heard me. Doors. Blocks. And hay bales and glue and varnish, all very hardware-y. Wouldn't you agree? We've got more things for you to decorate your farm. Blueprints for you to learn, more things to make. You've got more furniture, outside furniture, all kinds of furniture. And this is my favourite part, the overpriced sprinklers. I do like sprinklers, I use them a lot, but they are somewhat overpriced. At the moment, when we go to my farm, you will see that I have some large ones, but unfortunately they cost 18,000 each. Rather a lot, wouldn't you think? This is Elisa. She is the owner of the hardware store. She will look after all your hardware needs. I'm sure she's very happy that she's got random people walking all over her shop like this, never mind. In the world of Staxel, you need to make things. You need to build things. You need to create things. And in order to do all those things, you need a table, a workbench, something of that nature. These are some of them, like the saw, the assembly bench, the tiling bench. These are some of the ones you will use. That concludes the small tour of the hardware store, and that rhymes. Wow, accidental rhyming. Don't you just love it? So, let's move on to the next part. This is in fact the market. Yes, they sell some things the same as the other shops, but they sell some things that you might not find in the other shops. Also, the inventory in the other shops often rotates and changes, so if something is not in there, you might find it over there in the market instead. I myself am a farmer. The Whispering Wombat in Staxel is a farmer. I come here often to buy seeds for my farm. If I want to sell anything from my farm, I use this area here called a sell box. All of the people in the market are not very talkative, but they are very, very helpful and polite, and they wave at you. The next thing is the mayor's office. That is the mayor, Maximilian. The mayor of Staxel lives in the town hall. What a grand town hall, wouldn't you agree? With its working clock, its blue roof, its lovely architecture. If you ever have to come here for a meeting with the mayor, the first thing you need to do is have a word with the receptionist to confirm your appointment. Unfortunately, the receptionist is not here right now, but later when she is, that's what you would do. And then you would sit down on one of these comfy sofas or armchairs and wait for the mayor to summon you into his office. The offices are over here. this, after all, is the town hall, and it looks after all the records for all the citizens that live in the world of Staxel. Hence why we need so many filing cabinets here. And like I said before, the world of Staxel, for some reason, people love to have lots of cardboard boxes stacked, or crates stacked. They need a new cleaner in the town hall, because I found a spider's web. That can't be good up here too. So if you want to inhabit the world of Staxel, this particular world of Staxel, maybe you could become a cleaner and help the mayor. He definitely needs it. You see that in his offices, he does have lovely office spaces, again with computers, swivel chairs and desks, although unfortunately his choice of lighting is not very good in my humble opinion. It makes it look too much like a dungeon. This is a town hall, not a dungeon. I think I should have a word with him to get that changed and upgraded and improved, so that the lighting in there is much better. You see, I don't know who designed the lighting in here, but it has too much of a vibe of dungeons. When I come into the town hall, I don't want to feel like I'm coming into a dungeon. As you can see, it is now night time, but do not fear, I can go into someone's house and sleep in any bed. It's not an ideal situation, but hey ho, we make the best. Hello Amelia, sorry, I'm midway through a tour of Staxel, and I need to go to sleep. It's night time, I got stuck outside my farm. Please, can I sleep in your house? I'll take that as a yes. Now, Amelia lives in a very pink house. It does have a kitchen, and it has a rather big table in the dining area. And it also has a lovely checkered styling to all the furniture. You see, there's a checkered side table. There's a checkered sofa or couch, there's a checkered chair, there's a checkered armchair, there's a checkered coffee table and a lamp. The theming is great, wouldn't you agree? Pink and checkers, what's not to like? And as you can see, that theming continues in the bedroom with this lovely checkered style. Bedside tables, also checkered, funnily enough, another lamp and a big wardrobe to keep all her clothes in it, and a lovely area for making up or getting ready for going out, those kind of things. Now, it is in fact bedtime, so don't tell anyone, but I'm going to steal Amelia's bed. I'm sure she won't mind. Time to go to sleep. Time to rest up. And now I hear the pitter-patter of rain. It must be raining. This is the bathroom. For some reason, Amelia's bathroom has absolutely no lighting in it at all. She must be crazy. Or not very good at house design, because why would you have a bathroom with no lighting at all? What would you do at night time? Actually, not even night time. There's no windows in here, nothing. It should be pitch black in here. How does she do anything in her bathroom? I just don't really get it. I should have a word with her. Anyway, let's venture outside. So plants for you to decorate your farm or your house. More seeds, my favourite. Plants, more decorations like balloons, piles of gold, wind chimes. They've got it all. Even a beach chair. Would you believe they've even got a beach chair? Recipes for days. Recipes for days. Seeds for days, as the kids like to say. Ornamental chess pieces. Actual fruit and vegetable that you can use in your food. So that's why I like to call this the supermarket. Don't you just love the view out of the supermarket into the market square, especially when it's raining like this? It's very nice. Anyway, let's venture outside. This is a park, a small park. When they have a fence in Staxel, this area is also used for those events, but I don't believe they have any events on at this moment. Okay, I think I've shown you most of the things in the town square. I'm pretty sure we are ready to move to the most amazing, epic farm ever seen. Okay, let's get real. Maybe not that epic, but it's pretty good. If you consider I've only been in this world, this particular world of Staxel, for about 3 or 4 hours. This is the other park area. When there is an event in Staxel, for example, sometimes they have Easter events, sometimes they have fairy events. All of these events will use this area. This whole area will get filled up with things. It's pretty amazing. For example, in the Easter event, they have a giant maze here, which you can find eggs inside and other Easter related treats. It's pretty amazing, in my humble opinion. So here it is. Now, this is my farm. You know when I was saying about Easter event and you can get things? These are things that I won in the last Easter event, and these. And I thought, don't waste them, use them. So I thought to use them in the entrance to my farm so that everyone will know. This is my farm. There are four farms in this particular world of Staxel. I'm occupying one at this time. The other three are currently not in use. They are abandoned or derelict. But I'm hoping that soon other people will move into this world and take it over. Turn them into their own amazing farms. Now, as you can see, I have a dog. His name is Shadow. I called him Shadow because when I was a child, I had a dog and his name was Shadow. Shadow has a kennel and a bowl that I need to fill up with food soon. This is the entrance to my farm. I've got a hallway. Hallway? Why did I say hallway? hasn't grown enough to show its full potential. After you walk through the archway on my right is my farming area. I have many, many sweet potatoes right now. Like I said earlier, I like to use sprinklers. You may wonder why my planting area on the farm is in a funny star shape. That's because, unfortunately, these sprinklers only sprinkle water in a funny star shape. It's okay, I adapted, and actually I quite like it when I have dug out the area around the star shape, and eventually I want to put water in there. I think it will look really good. But first I need to fix this one, because I unfortunately made it one block too far to the right. I will correct that soon. I'm sure you can see all of the work I had to do to clear my farm area. Now it's ready for me to build and create my own farm. Over here is my barn for my cow, Mildred. Mildred is a very important part of this farm because she is great for my mood. She really helps me feel a lot better every day, especially when I do this. She also helps to give me milk. I made this barn using simple earth blocks. Maybe in the future I will upgrade and make a better one for Mildred. Inside the barn she has a couple of troughs with food inside for her to eat. I would encourage you to look at the design of my barn. I actually quite like it. It looks quite unique, although not very practical in real life. But this is not real life. This is the world of Staxel. I also used wooden blocks to make a kind of fence. Again, I'm sure in the future I will upgrade this. I haven't had time to do so yet. At the back of my farmhouse, I have somewhat of a surprise. That surprise is several beehives, or apiaries as they like to be called in this particular world of Staxel. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 beehives or apiaries. This one is ready for me to collect honey. This one is ready for me to collect honey too. This one is ready for me to collect honey too. This one, you're not gonna believe it, is ready to collect honey too. This one is ready to collect honey too. This one doesn't have a queen bee, so it's not ready for anything. So I need to use my bug net that looks like this, and I need to look around the world and find a queen bee. That is a bee that is wearing a crown. Yes, in the world of Staxel, some bees do wear crowns, and when you see that, you know they are a queen bee, and you catch them, and you bring them back, and you put them world of Staxel. This is very important. It helps you know the season, and it helps you know the different events in the world of Staxel. The seasons are very important as a farmer, as you may be aware. This is my bathroom. As you can see, it's nothing special, and I just realised the only lighting I have in here is a candle. But then again, at least I have some kind of lighting, unlike Amelia. This will be upgraded soon, and it will be the most amazing bathroom you've ever seen. Said all of this will be fixed, so I believe that the tour of the world of Staxel is now over. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned more about the game and the world of Staxel. I hope you also felt relaxed at the same time. Maybe I'll make other videos on this world when I build things. When I make things, when I discover fun things, maybe I will make more videos. But for now, thank you very much for watching The Whispering Wombat, and hopefully see you again next time.